This topic of discussion is six ways to identify research gap. Before going into the detail of the topic, let's first briefly describe what is research gap. Research gap refers to any unexplored research area of the topic or less explored research area of the topic which has the potential or good scope for the further research. So now, after defining, we will go into the detail that how we can identify the research gap. So there are three different ways or strategies which can be used to identify research gap. First one is exploration of the published literature for the inspiration. And for this, you should read books, research articles, research reports, systematic reviews, literature reviews. In this way, you will have a good glimpse of overview of the literature over a period of time, and you will be able to identify the research gap. That was exploration of published literature. The second approach is that you should list down all the possible questions which are coming into in your mind about the relevant topic and do extensive research individually on these research questions, that whether these research questions has been answered or not. If any one of these questions has not been addressed, probably there is a chance you have that you have found a research gap. Then after this step, you will be required to do the further research on the internet or in the digital libraries or in the physical libraries to confirm your finding that whether you have found any research gap or not. Then third way is the use of the digital tools. So you can use the Google Trends to identify the different trending research queries in your field, and you can using the digital tools you can find the most cited research papers and the popular contributors in your field, and by tracking the most cited papers and the popular contributors, you can identify the research gap. It will be also helpful in the exploration of the untapped research areas in your research field. And the fourth one is you should check the websites of the journals, probably the prominent journals. So, and you should explore the key concept section of the journals, as the key concept section of the journal contains the highlights of the central ideas relevant to the fields, and mostly experts are contributing in the key concept section of the journals. So reading through this section can help you to gain insight into your research area and generate new ideas. So you should, as you have already tracked the relevant experts and the contributors, so you should also check the reference papers or articles cited by these contributors. Fifth point is you should check the conclusion section of the every research paper. You should have go through the future prospect and conclusion section of the existing research papers, research articles, studies on your topics. Mostly authors give hint in these areas how their study have contributed in the present research and how it will be helpful for the future research. So from future prospect section, you can, if you carefully monitor the future prospect section, that will be helpful in the identification of the research gaps. That was the fifth strategy or approach. And last and the sixth one, which is very important, as you have gone through the five different approaches or the ways, now you should discuss all these approaches with your supervisor, and you should seek guidance from your research supervisor. You should discuss all the explored, tapped, untapped areas. You should discuss issues and problems which you faced in your research areas or research topic, and probably your discussion with your research advisor will be helpful, and it will be helpful in the final identification of the research gap or untapped area. So in this way, by following these six different approaches or the strategies, you can successfully identify the research gap.